Hello friends, in last video we have discussed about basic rules of addition and subtraction. Continuing with that, in this video we will discuss about rules of multiplication and division of errors. This is also the part of propagation of error. Suppose we have two measured quantities x and y, and these quantities have errors delta x and delta y. So we can write these quantities like x plus minus delta x and y plus minus delta y. Now suppose a new quantity z, that is the multiplication of these two quantities x and y, and we have to find the error in z. So for that we use the formula delta z over z equals delta x over x plus delta y over y. Here delta z is the error in z, delta x is the error in x, and delta y is the error in y. We can also write this formula in a different way in terms of percentage error. So for that we just multiply both sides by 100 like this. Left side multiply by 100, and now the right side is also multiplied by 100. So you can see this is the formula of percentage error. So we can write this whole term as percentage error in z, and this whole term as percentage error in x, and then this whole term as percentage error in y. So we got a new formula that says percentage error in z equals percentage error in x plus percentage error in y. So that means if you are given percentage error in x and percentage error in y, you can directly use this formula to find percentage error in z. So we have two kinds of formulas. If you are given errors, then you will use this formula. If you are given percentage errors, then you will use this formula. Same way, if the new quantity z is the division of x and y. X and y are given quantities. We can calculate error delta z by using same formula that I have given you for multiplication also. This is the same formula. Delta z over z equals delta x over x plus delta y over y. And the same way, if you multiply both sides by 100, then you can write the percentage error formula. So conclusion is, we have to use same formula for multiplication and division also. Let's take an example. Here are two given quantities, are distance and time, and we have to find speed and error in speed, that is delta s. You know speed equals distance over time. First we will find speed using the formula distance over time. Value of distance is 8.5 cm and value of time is 3.5. That will give us 2.43 meter per second. So this is the value of speed. Let's find error in speed. So we have to find delta s, and in that case we will using the same formula delta s over s equals delta d over d plus delta t over t. We have to find delta s. Value of s is 2.43 meter per second. Delta d equals error in d, that is 0.05 centimeter, and the value of d is 8.5 centimeter. The error in time is 0.02 seconds and the value of time is 3.5 seconds. This will give us 0.00588 and plus 0.00571. So delta s equals, we will get 0.0282 centimeter per second. This is the value of error. So we can write our answer as s plus delta s equals 2.43 plus minus 0.0282 centimeter. Now how we will find error in the product of powers. The same way, here we have two given quantities x and y, and their error says delta x and delta y. We have to find a new quantity z that equals x raised to the power m times y raised to the power n. So we can find an error in z using this formula, delta z over z equals, this is the power or exponent on x, this one. We have to multiply with delta x by x plus the power we have to multiply here and delta y over y. So keep in mind, this sign shows that either power is negative or positive. You have to put here a positive number. Like if power is given like minus m, even in that case, you will put here the positive value of m. And y, if minus negative n, even then you will put here a positive value of n. So you will use this formula, and if we multiply both sides by 100, this will give us a formula in percentage error. So we can say this is the percentage error in z equals m multiplied by percentage error in x and plus n multiplied by percentage error in y. So we got this final formula. Percentage error in z equals m times percentage error in x plus n times percentage error in y. Let's take an example. Here are two quantities are given. First is time and second is area. We have to find a new quantity w that equals t square divided by square root of a. We can write w as t raised to the power 2 and a raised to the power minus half. Square root means power is half, and it's in divide. When you take it on the top, the power would be negative. So first we will find the value of w that would give us t square divided by root a. So we will get value of t is 3 seconds, 3.0 to the whole square. Value of a is 4.52. That will give us 4.23. Now let's find out the error in w. Use the formula delta w over w equals delta t over t, and this would be multiplied by its exponent or power, that t has the power of 2. So we will multiply it by 2 plus delta a over a and multiplied by its power. Here you can see power is negative, minus half, but we will put always positive power, that is half. Now plug in all the values. Delta w over value of w is, we got here 4.23 equals to value of delta t is here 0.6. The value of t is 3.0 plus half. Delta is a is error in a, that is 0.02, divided by value of a, that is 4.52. Now you can solve this and you will get delta w equals 1.701. So we can write the answer as w plus minus delta w equals 4.23 plus minus 1.701. This is the answer. I hope you understand this topic here. If you have any question on this topic or any other physics topic, please ask the question in the comment box given below. Thank you.